One giant floor with thousands of pixels. Over £50,000 to be won. And tonight, it's a celebrity special. Welcome to a brand new series of Five Gold Rings. Celebrity edition of Five Gold Rings, the only show where you've got to find an answer and put a ring on it. Tonight, it's Corrie versus Emmerdale as we pair up our contestants with a star from each of the soaps. We're hoping they can win their teammate lots of money. You can compete with our celebs here tonight by playing along with us. Our app has been downloaded over a million times, so get involved if you want to see your name on our leaderboard. We'll be revealing the names of our highest scorers throughout the show. And that's not all. We would love you to tweet your photos playing along with us using the hashtag #5GoldRings, and you could see yourself on the telly as well. We'll be showing our favourites a little bit later on. And if you're playing along, good luck. Now, though, let's meet the teams. Playing tonight, Brenda from Yorkshire and Simon Gregson, best known for his role as Steve McDonald in Corrie. And playing against them, Frank from London and Matthew Wolfenberg. Gold Rings. How very lovely to see you all. Brenda, you are teamed up with Simon.
Yes.
And how do you feel about that?
That's wonderful. I've watched Coronation Street since the very beginning.
Have you? 1960. You don't look old enough to do that.
Yes. Wow. I was a 13-year-old.
So you know him very
well.
I've
watched you grow up.
Ah,
yes,
well.
Yes, you seem to have lost your twin, but...
He's in Spain, he's busy.
And how are you feeling you're going to do this evening?
I think we'll do very well. We've
I
had a
we'll
little chat,
right.
Haven't we?
So what did you chat about when you...
I just told Brenda to shout at me all the time. Don't take my word for anything. If you reckon it's right and I'm wrong, do it.
you brought five people with you.
Yes,
who at some stage, they'll be one of your lifelines.
Yes.
And they're up there now. It's your team of five.
Yes.
So who are they?
This is Pete. This is Steve. He's a work colleague of my son. This is Di. And this is Denise, my cousin, and this is my son, David.
It's lovely to see you all. Thank you very much indeed for coming. We will probably need you a little bit later on. If you were to win big, Brenda, with Simon's help, because the money he raises tonight on that floor is going towards you, what will you spend it on?
My house is looking a bit jaded at the moment, so a new kitchen might be very nice.
Lovely.
And I might treat the panel well if they, if they help me.
And if they don't?
Oh, I don't know.
Not a penny! Will you give them a huge round of applause? They are going to be playing against Frank and Matthew.
Hello.
Welcome, Frank. How lovely to see you.
Nice to see you too.
And so, how do you feel being partnered with Matthew here?
I think we've got quite a good team composition, you know. We've got a lot of things that are in common.
Yeah. And do you think you're going to do well this evening?
Average.
Average?
Set the bar there and then I can only improve.
You guys have already got quite a good rapport going on. So what do you think your strengths and weaknesses are?
We're just having a chat about this. We both seem to have similar strengths, don't we?
Like, yeah,
films,
really
music, the arts, anything beyond that, we're both pretty poor at.
Introduce us to your team of five.
OK, so first of all, that's my girlfriend there of 10 years, Chloe.
Hi, Chloe.
That's her mum, Kim.
Hi,
that's her uncle, Tony. This is my colleague slash mate, Pat, and that's my colleague slash mate, Tony.
Lovely. Well, it's lovely to see you all. And one of the things you want to do with your money is to go to Japan, isn't it? That's,
yep.
That's a big,
very big,
big
for
deal.
Us, yeah. Because obviously Japan's crazy expensive already, but going out there with that kind of money, just being able to relax and enjoy it, and then any leftover, I would probably say what I like to do is when I travel, I say travel, when I go on holiday, I like to buy ukuleles everywhere I go, just so it's kind of like a... You know, some people get tattoos or a pair of socks, ukulele. And then eventually get a wall of ukuleles.
What a thrill that must be, Chloe.
She's very lucky.
We wish you the very best of luck
Thank
with that.
Thank you very much. Fingers
Hope
crossed.
You do well tonight, both
Thank
of you.
You.
Thank you very much indeed. Massive round of applause. So here's how it works. Each team gets five gold rings. Each ring is worth a different amount of money, but as the money goes up, the rings get smaller and the answers become harder to find. They just place their gold ring around the correct answer. Get it right, they bank the money. Get it wrong, and the other team get a chance to steal. Both teams have two lifelines. They can flip the floor, that'll reveal a different question, or they can ask their teams of five what they think the answer is. And just to remind you, the celebrities are helping their teammates win the money themselves. The celebs are not going to win any of the money. We're cruel on here. Everybody ready? Let's play Five Gold Rings. Before the show, we flipped a coin. Brenda won and decided to play first. So, Brenda, here we go. Pop over there and pick up that giant gold ring. This is the biggest one. It makes it much easier to find what you're looking for. It's worth £1,000. Over you go. Pop yourself over there. Here we go with the question, Brenda. Best of luck for £1,000. Here is a map showing the islands of the Caribbean, but we have removed one. What we want you to do is to locate the island where Usain Bolt was born.
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay.
That's it, you're playing. On you go.
Damn it.
30 seconds starting from now.
Brenda, I have absolutely no clue.
Find the island where Usain Bolt was born.
Maybe go that way a bit, that way a bit, that way a bit. It's a total guess.
Sliding it across the floor, Brenda.
This is Panama, isn't it?
Six, five, four, three, two, one.
I have no clue. But I'm being positive, so that's a good thing.
Well done, Brenda. Did a great job there. So, have you found the answer for £1,000? Let's find out. Didn't. You did not manage to find it. So, Frank, you now have a chance to find that island where Usain Bolt was born. Time starts now.
Right, Frank, I'm in the same boat as Simon and Brenda were here. I couldn't tell you. I think it's going to be closer to one
eight,
of the other
yeah.
islands.
It's fair because I'm half Jamaican.
Five,
I should know this.
Four,
three,
three,
over that way. That's
two,
it, that's it. Leave it
one.
There.
That's it. So, you've had a go as well. What island were you looking for?
Jamaica.
You are looking for Jamaica. Are you right or wrong? Oh, are you joking? Okay, where is Jamaica? So that is where Jamaica is. The sad thing is that because you didn't steal it, that £1,000 is now gone.
Did we not get 500 for being closest?
No.
Got to ask. No.
Frank's just said his mum's not going to be very happy.
Because?
She's Jamaican and I'm half Jamaican. Geography is my literal weakest subject. I'm terrible with geography.
Yeah, but that's actually your heritage. It's not just geography. What's she called?
Sheila.
Sheila?
Sheila, that's what she called it.
Sorry, Sheila. Right, Frank, you've got a chance to redeem yourself here. It's your turn with your £1,000 giant gold ring. This is the big one. It's supposed to be hard to miss. So here is your £1,000 question. Here we go. So this is a timeline, and it's running from 1901 until 2000. What we want you to do is to place your £1,000 gold ring on the year that the first Live Aid concert was held.
Do you want to hear it? No,
play
it.
We'll play it.
No.
Yeah.
Right, OK, you are on. 30 seconds from now.
So when was it? 19...
So I believe 1985.
1985, that Queen I was going to say 80.
So this is 75.
Yeah.
So clearly I'm assuming moving up.
Yeah.
So I would say that's...
I think you're pretty... Pretty
Maybe
close
a bit more.
There, yeah.
Yeah.
1901.
Yeah, I think if you see 75, that's 50, about 60. 80.
Would it be not? Yeah. A bit further this way.
Yeah. Yeah. Two, try that.
Perfect.
One.
Yeah,
I'm happy with that.
That's it. You said the year that you thought it was, which was?
85.
1985. So, have you just managed to bank £1,000? Here we go. Within the £1,000 ring. So let's resolve this and find out whether or not it was 1985. And it was 1985. And there it is. Congratulations. You have just put £1,000 in your bank.
We're on the clock.
We're off and running. Now the game is going to get a little bit harder now because the rings are going to get smaller. The answers are harder to find. Simon, it's your turn. Mm-hmm. Over there is the £2,500 gold ring. There's the money on the floor. We'd love to put that in the bank. The very best of luck. Here we go with your question, Simon. This is a picture of Winston Churchill posing with his famous V sign. But as you can see, it's all been jumbled up. What we want you to do is to find the fingers of his V sign when the picture is put back in its correct order. You have two lifelines. Is it a lifeline?
Do it.
You're playing. 30 seconds starts now.
That was fun.
Go on.
Okay, right.
Find Churchill's V sign fingers.
Do you reckon there? Because his head's going to be body, head.
Find the fingers of his V sign.
Is it his left or his right?
Is that this hand? Yes.
Because his hand's down there, so it's his other.
Yes,
I reckon there. What do you think? What do you think?
Next
think
down.
How those tiles are going to move. 8 seconds.
Go on, Brenda.
Yes, leave it there.
Yeah, leave it there.
A bit further to
Three,
the line.
Two, one. That's it. Have you managed to get £2,500 into your bank account? Yes or no? Oh,
you're joking!
Nope, you were looking for Churchill's V-sign fingers and you didn't find them. Matthew, you're on with a steal. You've got 15 seconds. Starting from now.
Yeah,
well,
I agree.
Well, if you think about that, hand's going to be up here,
yeah,
isn't
it's
it?
Yeah, definitely, because so it's also at the corner of those pictures
about
as well.
There, because if you look where the fingers are in that one, about there.
Yeah, I think a little bit lower down. It's because it's in the corner of that
Four
picture.
Four fingers.
So, yeah,
three.
I'm confident with that.
Two.
I'm happy with that.
One. Yeah. Did you manage to steal the £2,500? Let's find out. Unravel this and you can see exactly what the picture looks like. It's a very famous shot. And there it is. And you have £2,500 in your bank. £3,500. Matthew is going to be playing next for £2,500, helping to increase Frank's bank to £6,000. Can he bank it or will Simon and Brenda have a chance to steal? We'll find out after the break.
For your chance to win £1,000 for free, download the app and enter before 10 a.m. on Friday. You must be 18 or over.
Welcome back to Corrie versus Emmerdale. It's Five Gold Rings, our celebrity special, where the stars from each soap are helping their team win loads of money, hopefully. Matthew is up next, and he's going to play the £2,500 ring. Grab that one, Matthew. You've already managed to steal Simon and Brenda's £2,500. So, can you get your own, or will you get your own back? Yeah. Let's see. Here's your £2,500 question. This is a freshly lit candle. It's 20 centimetres in height. The yellow line indicates the 20 centimetre mark. It takes exactly 12 hours to completely burn out. Can you find where the yellow line will be after 9 hours? You're gonna play it?
Let's try playing it.
Yeah. You are playing. You're on 30 seconds from now.
So 9 hours would be 3/4 the way down.
Okay.
It's obviously 3, 6, 9, 12. So 3/4 the way down. So 9 hours are much lower. Because it's 9 hours down to when he gets to the bottom. So in the bottom quarter, that's roughly
nine,
where it should be.
9, 10, 11, 12.
And then if you can sort of, yeah, because if you're looking at that, that looks like 3, 6, 9, 12, yep. Yeah, I'm happy with that.
Yeah, I don't think we're far off there.
No.
Yeah, you happy?
Yeah, very
definitely
happy, yeah.
There you go. Well, that's it. You did it with time to spare.
Yeah.
What are you smiling at?
Did you have a clue where that was going then?
No. I bet you that's right.
Are you right or wrong? Watch this candle burn down now, just to prove that that is the case. No steal for the guys over here.
It's gonna take 12 hours.
Yeah. There it is. That's where you were aiming for. £2,500 into your account. 6,000. So how are you getting on? Are you doing better than our celebs here tonight? Earlier we asked you to tweet photos. Let's have a look at what you've sent in. We've been trawling Twitter using the hashtag 5GoldRings, so hopefully we've managed to find you. So thank you for sending them in. They look absolutely brilliant. All you've got to do is tweet with the hashtag 5GoldRings and your picture could be shown live in everyone else's living rooms. If you are playing along on the app, how did you get on? Have you beaten the nation to reach the top spot? Let's find out. Here is where you are from, and this is who you are. Well done, congratulations, it's a very good score. And if you didn't spot yourself up there, whoever scores the highest in this second part of the show, you'll see your name hopefully a little bit later on. Just download the app for free and the very best of luck. Right, Brenda, you are playing next with the £5,000 ring. So pick that one up. You will feel that it is much, much lighter and smaller, but it's worth £5,000. You still have two lifelines. So here is your question. We are on Mars. The Curiosity rover has stopped and needs restarting, but the power cell has been lost. The bottom of the screen shows the size of the cell and that one step equals the length of one arrow. We've marked out where north is on the floor. Start at the center of the X and take 9 steps north and then 11 steps northwest.
Do you want to do
it? I'm happy with this.
Yeah,
happy with
it? Do it.
Okay.
You're playing. 30 seconds starting from now. 9 steps north from the center of that X. 9 north.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
And then 11 steps northwest.
So to, yeah. I'd say that was a bit north, north. Yeah,
10 seconds.
This way.
Northwest. Quick, quick, quick.
Okay, 11.
Four.
No, no.
Three.
No, more that way.
Two.
More
just
that way,
put it
Brent.
Down. Just put it down.
Put the ring down.
When you play this game, the most important thing is that that ring is on the floor.
Yes.
Because
I'm trying to think
you don't stand a chance if it's in your hands. So have you managed to find that cell? We
no.
ask you to take 9 steps north and 11 steps northwest. What do you think, Simon?
No. I think we went north, north, northwest. As opposed to northwest.
Right, here we go. Let's see whether or not, by some incredible miracle, you have managed to find that £5,000. Oh.
shock.
So, you didn't manage to find it?
No.
Luckily, I know a kitchen guy.
You are in for a steal. So, it's Frank, go for it. Go and find that power cell. 15 seconds, time starts now.
Go, go, quick, quick, quick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, now 11. Go on. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Three, yep. 2, 1. That's it.
Yeah.
For a £5,000 steal, have you managed it? No. So, let's find out where it is. Oh! There's the track. 9 steps north and then 11 steps northwest. Unfortunately, nobody managed to find that power cell, which means that's £5,000 on the steal and it's gone. Ah! Right, Frank, you're back on. Yep. Pick up that £5,000 ring and let's see whether or not we can put that in your bank account. Stay alert, guys, because you could be in for a steal here. You still have 2 lifelines. Here we go. We are staying in space. So there is the planet Saturn, famously known for its rings. And we can see a space rocket on a mission to explore the rings. But an asteroid field has blocked our view. Keep a close eye on the rocket, because what we want you to do is to find the point at which it crosses Saturn's rings.
I think pass it on to... Yeah.
So you played a lifeline. And are you going to flip the floor and have a look at something else, or do you want to use your team of 5?
Give it to the team of 5, yeah.
You are giving it to the team of 5. They have been playing along, so let's see where they have placed their 5 gold rings. Oh.
Oh.
Well, when they're in more or less the same place, that's actually quite handy. But unfortunately, they are not. You have to decide whether or not you're going with them or whether or not you are going out on your own. You've used that lifeline. Your time starts now.
OK, Frank, the ring that's nearest the centre, I think that is the most...
This one?
Yeah, I think that one, but maybe a little this way, behind
this way,
to
right.
That way.
Where's
not
the
much.
Gone?
I think that one's pretty accurate. What do you think?
Oh, wait, there it is. Hold on.
15 seconds.
You might not have long enough
time,
to see it go around.
I see what you mean. Yeah, I can see it being in this general area.
Yeah.
Unless it randomly veers.
It depends what it does when it goes. Yeah. Yeah. I think that one's the best bet.
Three,
yeah, happy
that?
I do. I'm happy as well.
1. That's it. Time's up.
That was where when I was looking. That's where I was. What do you think?
Have you managed to find the point where the rocket passes through the rings of Saturn? Yes or no? Let's look at the full pattern here so we can see that there's the path. There we go. The great thing is that £5,000 now goes into your account. It's 11K. £11,000 over here. There's nothing in that bank account just yet. There are 4 rings to go. Could Frank and Brenda bank a total of £35,000. Who will claim that money? You'll find out after the break.
For your chance to win £1,000 for free, download the app and enter before 10 a.m. on Friday. You must be 18 or over.
Celebrity edition of 5 Gold Rings, where our soap stars Simon Gregson and Matthew Wolfenden are helping their teams win big tonight. As the money gets bigger, the rings get smaller. It's Simon's turn to play now. Right, we're on the £7,500 one now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Yep.
So stop mucking about.
I'm not!
Right, I'm at £7,500. That's what we need. We need that £7,500 in here. You still have 2 lifelines. Best of luck with this now, Simon. And here we go. So here is a coffee cup, and we have added a 20-milliliter espresso shot. The 20-milliliter mark is indicated by the yellow line. We are going to add 53 millilitres of hot milk to the cup. Can you find where the yellow line will be once the milk is added?
Hit the button, Brent!
Right, you've decided that you were going to play Lifeline. What are you going to do? You're going to go with your team of five, or are you going to flip the floor and look at another question?
Team of five.
I reckon team of five,
team
Brenda.
Team of five.
Right, OK, we're going to go with a team of five. Hopefully, they are going to help you get this £7,500. You really, really need this. They've each got a tablet. They've been playing along with the question. Where is the yellow line when 53 millilitres of milk are added to a 20-millilitre espresso shot? Whoa, now that's a reasonable line you've got there. So you now have to decide whether or not you're going to go with that team of five or whether or not you're going to go rogue. Your time starts now.
OK, so, So I'm thinking about there. What do you think, Brenda? Should I go there or there?
Put it down.
There.
Put it down.
Oh, yeah. Put it up. Sugar.
Yeah. Up a little bit.
Up.
Yeah.
Good with it?
8 seconds.
Where?
Four, three, two, one. That's it. Time's up. Okay, Simon, Brenda, do you have £7,500? Let's have a look.
Let's see.
Yay! Yay!
Right in the middle. Oh.
Do you know what? I can say this now. No one has ever got to the end of the game with nothing in the bank. Let's see how you managed it. Let's complete this question and add the milk. There it comes. There it is. Thank you very much indeed. Job done. You have £7,500 in your bank account.
High five, Brenda.
See, right, Matthew, it's your turn now.
Good luck, mate.
On you go. £7,500. So, that would look fantastic in here.
It would indeed.
Here we go with your £7,500 question. You have your lifeline still, should you choose to play it, but you won't know until you see this. This is the Five Gold Rings karaoke booth, and here are the lyrics to the chorus of Pray by Take That. But some of the words are missing. If the font size and the letter spacing of the lyrics remain the same, where should the letter L be in love? You've got your lifeline.
Let's try playing it, shall we?
Yeah, play it.
OK, that's it, you're on.
Right.
30 seconds starting from now. Find the letter L in the word love.
All I do each night is pray, hoping that'll be a part of you again someday. You've got this. Is that in the right line?
I've gone to another line.
I think you're in between two lines. What line are you supposed to be on? Fourth or third?
Huh?
All I do each night is pray, hoping that'll be a part of you again
someday. 10 seconds. Find the L in love.
You're in between two lines, that's what I'm saying.
What do you think, this one?
I don't know. Here.
Four, three, two,
go a bit lower.
One.
Yeah, that is a toughie.
Have you managed to find the L in the word love? If you have, that £7,500 goes into your account. If you haven't, you're in with a steal here. Where is the L in love? You were struggling with that right from the word go, but now, Simon, hopefully, I hope you know this song. You are on for the steal. Go for it.
Am I going there?
Yes, you are.
Quickly.
That's it. Your time
down a bit and
starts
further out.
Now.
You reckon further out, Brenda?
Down a little bit and then further out.
There.
Not so much. Nearer the hole, but not touching.
There.
And a bit further down.
You know the words.
Can you see
Four,
a straight line?
Three.
Yeah, that's it.
OK.
One. That's it. Have you stolen Frank's £7,500? right or wrong? Haven't. Let's have a look. Here's the L. There. Oh, I can't believe it. What a shame. That means that £7,500 has disappeared. What a shame. Whoever has the most money after these last two rings will take control of the final. Brenda, it is your turn to take to the floor. And if you wander over there, you'll see just how small that £10,000 ring is. You have £10,000 in your hands there, Brenda, potentially. There it is on the floor. You still have your flip the floor lifeline. Here is your question for £10,000. It is an image of a beluga whale, but as you can see, we have removed its eye. So what we want you to do is to place your ring around where you think its eye should be.
We can still have that question. Press the button.
Simon. Come on. You were just looking then.
I can't think of it. No way, that's why.
You can come back to it. Let's flip the floor and have a look at an alternative question. You can decide which of the two of these you would like to play. It's a timeline running from 1901 until 2000. What we want you to do is to place your ring on the year in which the English archaeologist Howard Carter and his team discovered the tomb of Tutankhamun.
Flip, please.
You're not playing this one?
No. The whale, please.
You're playing the whale. Right, let's resolve this one. What year was it, first of all? Let's find out. Oh, it's down there. And it's 1922. However, you are going to play the other side. So let's flip it back. It's worth £10,000. Find the beluga whale's eye now.
Put it down, Bren. I think it's just a little bit down this way. A little bit down towards the mouth, a little bit towards you, a little bit more, a little bit, no, down, 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 no, up, 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 a little bit more, a little bit more, a bit towards you, tiny bit. Up, 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 a little bit, there.
There. I think it's there, you've got 15 seconds.
I think it's there.
So have a look at it, check it out, see what it looks like. 10 seconds. 5 seconds, 4, 3, 2, 1, that's it. Time is up. Place the ring down now. That is your £10,000 committed. There is a chance of a £10,000 steal. If you were here playing, could you win that £10,000? You'll find out after the break. The clash of the soap juggernauts here tonight. Simon from Corrie and Matthew from Emmerdale try to win loads of money for their two team members. You join us at a very tense moment in the show before the break. Brenda and Simon were trying to find the beluga whale's eye. So have you managed to get £10,000 or is this a steal? Where is the beluga whale's eye? No, that is not where the beluga whale's eye is. You're on.
Perfect.
Go for it. You have got the chance to steal their £10,000. Your time starts now.
Well, 15 seconds, so...
So I'm thinking...
I think closer to the mouth.
Yeah, like almost kind of this-ish.
Yeah. Sorry, I mean, if you look at it like that...
I am sort of on
five,
top of it.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, that's it. Did you manage to steal the £10,000? Here we go.
No, you didn't.
No, you didn't. So the big question is, if you electronically remove a beluga whale's eye, where should it be? There it is.
What? Oh. We were thinking of the different beluga whale.
Ah, but not that beluga whale.
The bejuga whale.
The sad thing is, and this is horrible, that is a lot of money to throw away, but that £10,000 is now gone. We've just lost 10K out of the pot. However, there is £10,000 for you, Frank, on offer. Pick up that ring.
Come on, Frank.
And this could be your shot at £21,000. You still have your flip the floor lifeline. So, here we go. It's a map of the UK and Ireland. What we want you to do is to place that £10,000 ring around the castle in which Prince Harry and Meghan Markle got married. Right, you're going to flip it. That's the lifeline you've got left available, so we'll come back to this one if you fancy it after you've seen the alternative. Let's flip the floor. This is what's on the other side. It's an eagle flying over water, possibly about to try and grab its dinner. However, its reflection is incomplete. What we want you to do is to find where its beak should be in the mirror image. You play this one or you play the castle?
Definitely this one. We spoke earlier and geography is our absolute weakest subject for both of us.
OK, let's flip that back. All you've got to do is to find where Prince Harry and Meghan Markle were married. You've no clue on this one.
I know where, Windsor, but no idea on the map.
So shall we find it out? Where were you pointing then?
There.
There? Come out and play. Right, where is it then?
There.
There?
I think.
You think it's there? You think that's where Windsor is?
It's there. Yeah?
It's not there. I know it's not there.
Where is it?
Well, why don't we just go like that? Because that's the inside of the room. Right, OK. Whereabouts did they get married? Let's have a look.
Oh, look! Told you.
That's brilliant. That means we add absolutely nothing to your prize fund. Right, we get serious now because this is worth £10,000. Your question is, it's an eagle flying over water, possibly about to try to grab its dinner. However, its reflection is incomplete. What we want you to do is to find where its beak should be in the mirror image. Your time starts now.
Go on, Frank, step
so
it
I think,
out.
Yeah, just step out, isn't it? So, two, three, four
and a half,
three quarters,
like a bit,
I think, yeah.
Yeah.
So, one, two, three, four and three quarters, which is like here.
Yeah, and let's just make sure it's not, it needs to come this way a bit, this way, slightly. Slightly more, there.
Yep, you sure?
Four, sure. Three.
That way a little bit
yeah.
more.
Two,
yep.
That's it.
£10,000,
right or wrong, did you find the beak in the mirror image?
Yes! Come on!
Oh, genius! Well done.
Look at that.
Let's resolve this now so that we show you the full picture. And there it is. And there is the eagle's beak. Absolutely spot on. And that £10,000 is now in your account. Let's take a look at the final scores. So we've got £7,500 over here. We've got £21,000 over here. That is a very, very tidy sum of money. So Frank and Matthew have the most money. They will have control of the final. You said at the beginning of this show that you wanted to, you know, increase your ukulele collection. Bearing in mind you're now looking at £21,000, have you adapted your dreams?
Yeah, just more ukuleles. No, of course. I think when we go to Japan, it's almost we could be, you know, first class, really special. And you know, it's been 10 years, so really special.
Yeah, do it
not
in style.
Not dropping hints. Yeah.
Do it in style. Really? Okay. And over here, we've got Brenda, who's got £7,500, not to be sniffed at. You were talking about a kitchen earlier on.
Yes.
How will that get you near to what you want to be?
Yes.
Good. Right, before we play the final, thank you so much for playing along. Let's take a look at some of the photos that you've been sending in up and down the country, people playing the game. Fingerprints on the telly screens. Look at that. Glad you've got involved with us tonight. We absolutely love getting them. Hopefully you have spotted yourself. They are brilliant. If you are playing on the app, how did you get on? Have you beaten the nation and our celebrities here? Let's find out. Here's where you are from. Is it you? Is it you? Is it you? It's you! There you are. You are our leader this evening. Well done. Congratulations. Right, it's time to play the final. We go, and the very best of luck. So we have £7,500 over here. We have £21,000 over here, which means, Frank, that you have control of the final. That means I will ask a question. You look at that question and decide whether or not you want to play it. If you play it, you will play it with the larger ring over there. If you get it right, you'll win your £21,000. If you get it wrong, then Brenda will win her £7,500. You have another alternative. You could look at that question and think, I don't want to play it. You could force Brenda to play, and she's got a smaller ring over there, making it much harder. If she gets it right, she wins her money. If she gets it wrong, you win yours.
Yep.
So those are your choices. You can't make that choice until you have seen the question. The decision you make here could be £21,000 or nothing. Here's your question.
No pressure.
It's a memory question. Here are some British coins spinning around on a table. Keep a close eye on them as they move around, because in a moment they are going to settle and they are going to disappear. Keep an eye on them. And they've gone. Find where the 5p coin ended up before it disappeared. You playing or passing?
Matt seems very confident, so I think we're going to play it.
You're going to play it, right?
Yeah.
OK, Matt.
Go
pick
on,
up that ring.
I trust you.
Hang on, somebody passing me. I've got my eye on the floor.
You can do it. You can do it. You can do it. There you go.
There
you can help him.
Makes a dream work.
Find the 5p coin. Time starts now.
Right. Did you have a clue
here
at all?
Yes,
down here,
and it was like
it?
10, 20 and
I think
5.
It was around there. I watched it. I watched that one for some reason. That one drew my eye.
Still got 20 seconds.
And I was watching. The 50p was over here. The pound was here.
The two was
find
there.
Where the 5p coin ended
it was 20,
up.
20, 10 and 5.
Are you happy with that?
We
both saw it. We both saw it.
Yeah.
So no, you're happy with that?
Five,
I think it'll
four,
leave me there pretty
three,
close. So
two,
let's go with it.
One.
It's there or thereabouts, mate. It is there or thereabouts.
So, the placing of that ring is the difference between £21,000 and nothing. The placing of that ring for you guys over here is £7,500 or nothing. For £21,000, Frank, and that's a hell of a trip to Japan.
Yeah.
Did you manage to find the 5p coin? Here they are. In they come.
Which one's the 5p?
I don't know yet.
You've got a coin that's going close to the ring. Which one is going close? Which one is going close? Which one is going close? Which one is it? There's one in there. What is it? What is it? What is it? It's the 5!
Oh, fucking bruise.
Gosh,
oh, well done.
Oh, my God, thank you so much.
That is quite incredible. Guys, I'm so sorry. Brenda, it's been so lovely to have you here.
I've had a lovely time.
And I'm
thank
glad
you.
It was tricky to get off the mark. £7,500 is a lot of money to lose, but thank you. And And Simon, thank you so much for playing. You've been really, really good fun. I've loved it. Thank you.
Thanks
mate.
For having me.
However, you've won £21,000.
Yeah. Hasn't gone. Hasn't sunk in.
Why don't you both join me out here? Come down here and have a look. There it is. That is what £21,000 looks like. Well done, guys. That's it. Tonight's winner, Frank, takes home £21,000. Well done to him. We'll see you next time on Five Gold Rings. Bye-bye.